So there are all these different ways you can think about what recognition is. And one of the two main distinctions we already talked about, but it pays to point it out again, is this difference between single instance labeling. Okay, so here's a picture of a car, and we say, you know, that's John's car. Okay, and so we want to be able to find that particular thing versus we'd like to be able to find all of these things and say, okay, those are cars. For the most part, we're going to be worrying about this problem, the generic categorization problem. Okay, so object categorization can be described a variety of ways. This was a slide from Kristen and Berent Liebe, and then I changed a little bit. Generically, it's kind of like this. Given some number of training examples, training images of a category, recognize some a priori unknown instances of that category and assign the correct label. Now, you'll notice that I put down small in parentheses. You know, right here it says small. These days, not a lot of work is done on the small number. That is, typically we have lots of large examples, and there's a question about how methods that go from taking large data could then use small data. To me, that's a slightly more interesting problem, but we'll leave the small as being sort of optional at this point. But the basic idea is that I give you a set of these things and some sort of labels, and you want to give me back the correct label. All right. So one of the things we have to do before we can even proceed is we have to agree on a set of labels. And there's this fundamental problem that a single object doesn't have a unique label. So here we have somebody's dog apparently named Fido. I don't know if anybody names their dogs Fido anymore. So you can say, well, this is Fido, or you could say this is a German Shepherd. You could say this is a dog. You could say it doesn't even say, you could say it's a mammal. You could say it's an animal. You could say it's a living thing, although a living being is probably, I don't know, etc. But it is these things, right? So there's this question is, what categories are best for visual identification, or which ones do we agree upon?